Touched on what is the latest way to undermine anyone who opposes him. Watch this.
You don't hand matches to an arsonist, and you don't give power to an angry left-wing mob, and that's what the Democrats have become. They would turn our country so fast into Venezuela, and Venezuela's not doing too well, folks.
So we are hearing that time and time again. Who was he talking about?
Well, I guess what he was talking about is the women who are very angry and expressed their anger, I think, quite adamantly during the Kavanaugh hearings, because they were women who had gone through the trauma and the tragedy of being sexually assaulted at some point or maybe several times during their lifetime. And they were trying to tell their stories to Republican men who did nothing but either run away from them or completely make fun of them, treat them disrespectfully and in a manner that just dripped of disdain and denigration. And so for me, the more that he talks about an angry mob and the more that women understand that he's talking about them and complaining about them when they were trying to tell their mm-hmm. stories, the better it is, not just for Democrats, but for independents and those, frankly, moderate Republican suburban women yeah. who don't like what this country has become under Trump and Republicans who have wrapped themselves around him.
Alice, before you answer, I want you to keep that passion, but your party won, right? They have the White House, they got the Congress, they have two handpicked justices in the last year. People who don't agree with it are exercising one of their options, which is protest. Is calling them a mob, is that a bit much?
No, not when you see what they've been doing. Look, I don't think you need to tell me that we won. You need to tell those people out there that are banging on the doors of the Supreme Court and chasing senators out of public restaurants and yelling at senators in elevators. Look, the Republicans won. They knew that that meant that the president would have the opportunity to appoint one, possibly two nominees to be confirmed on the Supreme Court, and they should actually acknowledge that. If they spent more time handing out voter registration forms across the country, they'd be much more effective
with
their current tactics.
Yeah, but Alice, that doesn't mean that people don't, I mean, honestly, that doesn't mean that people don't get to object. I mean, that's your right as an American to object. It's covered in the First Amendment. It's like the first one.
Yep.
Sure, they
petition
certainly can.
Your government.
Sure, they certainly can do that. But what he's saying, and we're seeing it across the country, going to a restaurant and screaming at an elected official in a public restaurant. And they did the same to Sarah Sanders. They've done the same to Kirstjen Nielsen. They've done it to many members of this administration because they object with the policies of this president and what the elected officials were elected to do. That's not how you go about doing
it. But that's not what he's talking about.
That's
exactly
what he's talking
about. Imagine what would happen.
Imagine
what would happen. Let's just turn this around. Hillary Clinton wins, and she names Supreme Court nominees. Republicans are upset. Imagine if there was a Democratic senator and his wife at a restaurant and the alt-right, you know, Richard Spencer's crew comes rolling in, yelling at them, berating them, trying to shame them, and
that's
they end up having to leave a restaurant.
Matt. You had me until you said...
Hold on, Matt. Don't call that a mob. Those are protesters.
Until you said alt-right, you had me.
Okay, what if it, say Tea Party? Let's forget the alt-right. It's Tea Party. Let's say Tea Party protesters.
Okay, that is a better example than the other one.
Would we be wringing our hands and clutching our pearls and saying we can't call that a mob? Those are protesters. No, that is mob behavior.
How many times does that happen?
Everybody stop! Matt, we already did that. We already said they weren't mobs.
They are mobs.
No. We already said that the Tea Party people, we went through this, in case you don't remember.
No, because the Tea Party people didn't hound people
out of restaurants. The Tea Party people hounded me when I went out to cover them. And you know what I said? It was their right to do it because they're Americans.
Don, if they started following you around to restaurants and running you out of places and
I would say they're wrong because I'm not an elected official.
Look, it would be a mob.
I'm not an elected official. If I put my name on a ballot... And I
They're
won
gonna come after
office.
Journalists, Don. This is going to happen.
Journalists
what's
are not
stopping them
public
from coming
officials.
After journalists?
They're not
following
public
us
servants.
Around everywhere we go.
But
they're not
the
public
problem.
Servants.
I think
here's
there is
the
a small element
Trump,
of truth on
Trump
both.
Isn't just Trump isn't just talking
here?
About those
can I say
yeah.
something, please?
Let Max
I
get
think
in.
There is a small element of truth on both sides here, which is that there is incivility on both sides of the political spectrum. And I deplore activists who are hounding public officials and restaurants. I think that's wrong. It backfires. It feeds into the victimization yeah. narrative that Trump tries to put out there. It's counterproductive. But on the other hand, Donald Trump is in no position to complain about mob rule when he is yeah. speaking tonight in front of an actual mob and they are chanting, lock her up, about Senator Dianne Feinstein. He is in no position to talk about mob rule when he incites his followers at these rallies such that members of the media who are there often feel threatened. And in fact, during the campaign in 2016, there was actual violence at the Trump rallies, okay? That is mob rule. As much as anything else,
yeah.
I think we all need to calm
yeah,
down,
I,
take a
I
step
agree,
back,
and when,
try
and
to
when
conduct
you know,
the debate.
Be condemned.
And
here's the deal. Let me talk for one
finish.
Second.
Let him
this
finish.
Is a difference.
You're not,
no,
Matt,
this
you're
is
not,
a difference
finish,
between
Matt, and
conservatives
and liberals.
What you're complaining about, which is
I'm trying to agree with Matt.
Without civility
but
here. Okay, let me finish.
Okay?
We on both sides. We need greater civility. And Donald Trump is not showing that kind of civility when he accuses Democrats, for example, of being traitors who are going to turn this country into Venezuela. That is not reasonable, civilized discourse. And so, yes, there, you can complain about the tactics of some progressive activists, but you've got to be fair and talk about the tactics of the right and of Donald Trump as well, and they are deplorable.
Right.
Frankly.
And
Matt,
let
Matt, let Matt get in. Matt, go ahead.
Nobody is condoning
center-right
journalists and liberal activists is, I will admit that it's wrong for Donald, that it is a mob behavior, it is a mob mentality when Donald Trump and the people say, lock her up. I'm willing to admit that. I'm waiting for liberals and, you know, intellectually honest liberals to admit that when you harass Ted Cruz at a restaurant, that is also mob-like behavior. Why is it that I'm willing to concede that Donald Trump is a bad person and that that's mob behavior, but I never hear liberals come on or center-left journalists
I am about to say that that kind of behavior, following senators or any other elected official into a restaurant when they're with their family, I don't agree with that. I do
is
not
it mob
condone
behavior?
That.
I don't know how many were there.
I don't even know.
Let's show the video, John. You got some B-roll.
How many were there?
Let's show the video.
I gotta get to the break. I'm gonna answer your point. Hey, both of you, please stop. Okay, I've got to get to the break. I will answer your question that you asked to her. Is it mob behavior? No, it's not mob behavior. It's people who are upset and they're angry with the way the country is going and the policies that these people. Will you let me finish, Matt, please, before you jump in? Okay. I'm making a point. I can't make it if you keep interrupting me.
No, but you're making a point. Are you the moderator or the host, or are you arguing a liberal?
I'm the moderator and the host of this show,
my.
And I'm trying
now
to make a
like
point
a
to tell you that now you're giving mob
Matt,
rule. I'm telling you why people are
saying it's not a mob. Look up the word mob in the dictionary.
Matt,
it is by definition,
you
mob
should
behavior.
Look up the word mob in the dictionary. And you should also, as a Republican, look at the Constitution.
I'm not a Republican.
And look at the or whatever it is you are. Whatever it is you are, look at the Constitution of the United States, and it gives people the right to protest.
Yeah,
and that it doesn't say where you can
especially
protest and how you can protest and to what.
Illegal.
Will you
nobody
let me
saying,
finish, Matt? Please, let me finish.
Fine.
Okay.
Bring it on.
Okay.
Do you mind if I have a drink?
So you can do whatever you want. You can leave the show if you want, but let me finish.
I'm not
I will make
do
my
that.
Point. Okay. Well, then shut up and let me do it. All right.
Please.
Thank you very much. In the Constitution, you can protest whenever and wherever you want. It doesn't tell you that
yes.
you can't do it at a restaurant. It doesn't tell you that you can't do it on a football field. It doesn't tell you that you can't do it on a cable news show. You can do it wherever you want. And to call people mobs because they are exercising their constitutional right is just beyond the pale. We'll be right back.
If conservatives did it, you'd call it a mob.